Hello. Admiral Cold Arms, welcome to the stream. Hello, I'm playing a depressing video game. Arty stream. Hell yeah.
Dab.
You can't see me dab, but I just dabbed. I'm playing Omori because I want to play Omori. I have to go to a spider place. Yeah.
Dab.
If I understood anything about how to make it happen, I would 100% add the capability to make my funky little cat girl dab. But unfortunately, I do not understand in the slightest how to do that. So you'll just have to take my word for it that when I say I dab, I dab.
Dab.
Oh boy, oh boy. I've been waiting so long for this event. It is a delightful day indeed. Some fucking sprout moles and shit. Oh yes, at last our glorious princess sweetheart will finally make her appearance. Oh my, I can hardly contain my excitement. This show is sure to be one of the most electrifying of them all. I added the one of the most because I fucking don't know how to speak. Oh dear, we must hurry. Our four front row show tickets are right here. We are in for the time of our lives and must not be late. Now, which way do we go again? I like how when sprout moles get lost, they become hostile. It's funny. It's cute. Anyways, I'm gonna... Oh, Aubrey doesn't have any juice. I should probably, fix that. Sprout mole is 200% emotion. Yeah. Pretty much. Alright, can these guys, like, just please stop hurting us? Well, actually, I guess it doesn't really matter. I will turn you into bread, though. I already fought the Earth. I fought the Earth, and I barely won. But, I did win! Yeah, I didn't realize he was gonna be so hard, and literally, it was by the skin of my teeth, and, I think everyone was bred except for Omori. And, I used up, like, almost all, if not all of my, life jam. So, yeah, I learned the hard way that Earth is a difficult planet. I should probably mute my, phone, because it's right in front of the microphone. We got show tickets. Hey, cool, these sprout moles dropped some tickets. Let me see. Oh, they're front row seat tickets for some kind of show. Featuring Sweetheart? Wasn't that Captain Spaceboy's ex-girlfriend? Yeah, it looks like some sort of contest or something. If we happen to pass by, we should stop and watch. We do have front row show tickets, after all. Well, alright. Maybe we can drop by if we happen to come across it. Yeah, literally, it is just kill it until it dies more. That's such an accurate descriptor. Bop-ba-da-bop-bop. It's just the Earth just won't die for some reason, you know? It's the Earth. It's the planet. I don't know. I'm playing with an 8-bit DOE controller that looks like an SNES controller. And it just feels fitting for this game. Not gonna lie. Not to say that it is required for this game, but it's just fun, you know? It's just fun to use, like, a pseudo SNES controller. For a game that is like a pixel art RPG. Yeah, like I like using this controller for Undertale too and stuff. It's a fun controller for 2D games, you know. And yeah, humans did fuck the Earth. This is what you get, my super laser piss. But I'm not gonna fuck the Earth, I'm gonna go higher. I'm pissing on the moon. That's right, Omori. I pissed on the moon, you idiot. Thanks for taking one for the team. Alright, and now we're in Pyrefly Forest. Ooh. It's full of spiders. Ugh. On second thought, let's look for Basil somewhere else. This place gives me the heebie-jeebies. Don't be such a baby, Kel. There are just some spider webs here and all. Oh, here and all. Here and there. Jeez, I really can't read. Ah! There's a spider in your hair! Where? What? Get it off! Ha, just kidding. Look who's the scared one now. It's not very funny, Kel. Oh, you funky little children. Yeah. There's an empty joke book here. I'll take a little joke book. After interacting with the tentacle poking out of the ground. Surface of the water is shimmering. Do you want to throw 10 clams in the lake? You know, I have 1,197 clams. I think I can afford to throw 10 clams into the lake. Hey, it's me, Weeping Willow, the goddess of the lake. Thanks for the clams, I guess. They say that money can buy happiness, but apparently it's not working. Can you do something funny for me? Maybe tell a joke? Doesn't look like you have any material on you. Come back when you have a joke or two. Okay, I think this is like a side quest. In which case, I shall come back later. I think this... Alright, yeah, that's like... Alright, there's a Walter Melon. I will acquire the sire of a chicken wing. I love that, like, the chests in this game are watermelons because it's just, like, it's just cute, you know? Breadfruit juice. Oh, boy. Oh, wait, I think... Okay, yeah. Alright. It's been a hot... Alright, so I played, like, the good ending of this game. We're on the Hikikomori route, currently, because I haven't played through that, and I wanted to, because, suffering. So, estrogen strength, you know what they say, estrogen is the bestrogen. It's definitely Herculean in nature, you know. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. Gives you booba, you know. And who can really complain with that except for people that will you know, are allowed to complain about that because, you know. But like, if you want booba and you get booba, you know, yeah. Estrogen is the best. What to read, sigh. I've read every book on this shelf over 20 times already. If only I had something more interesting to read. Okay, so now we gotta get a book. Part of me is like, oh, I should do a lot of this, of the side quests, you know? I should do a bunch of side quests. But then another part of me is like, that's probably gonna take a while, and I'll probably forget a good bunch. True. That's pretty much what I was, like, getting at, you know? Like, transmasculine individuals, you're allowed to complain about booba, you know? That's perfectly valid. But, like, if you're a trans-feminine person, you know, or just, like, yeah. Even, like, yeah. 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 Booba. Booba's my favorite Teletubby. I also love how, like, a reoccurring enemy, like, instead of a slime monster, they're all, like, rabbits, and it's different types of rabbits all throughout this game. It's really cute. I gotta just quickly click on... I've been noticing I have, like, occasional issues with the program... the program I use for the avatar I use, where occasionally it'll just disconnect and it'll just make me frozen, or whatever. But I think if I like keep it clicked on as the primary window, it doesn't do that. So because I have two monitors, I just have it on my second monitor, and I just have it clicked on, and I just play through the OBS window, because my capture card is pretty good. I think it's like the HD60S or whatever. The Delgado, as the Jablinski Games would once call it. And yeah, the best Rust Ball is the ones you grow yourself. So that's so true. That is so true. I've never heard a more true statement in my life. Oh god, that's so true. I didn't even notice Kel become toast. Oh no. Oh no. Okay, Aubrey, you gotta deal some damage, but not too much damage. Aw, damn it! Mori can never move at the pace in which I need him to move. Like, I always need him to move last, but, like, he never moves last whenever I, like, try to plan out a bread slice. But since I'm, like, so early on in the Pyrefly Forest, I'm just gonna, like, go back to Mari. You know? I'm just gonna walk back to the playground, or more so run back, just so I get a hashtag free heal. Which is I'm probably gonna do this, and then the next picnic basket is going to be, like, the immediate next, screen. So I'm definitely, just wasting time. But, so true. Amori does love painting with red colors, especially not blood. Definitely not blood. It's really funny, because, like, yeah. I feel like if teenage me had access to this game, they would, like, probably vibe with it a lot. Just because I was one edgy motherfucker. But, like, I would vibe with it without understanding it, you know? Whereas I'm an adult who, now, in the modern era, who, like, understands it and still kind of vibes with it, but, like, I at least understand it now, for the most part. As opposed to, like, teenage me, who would vibe with it on a surface level and not understand any of the depth or complexities to it. Yeah, I mean, I am 23 years old. It's just, like, I don't know. I say teenage me like I'm 35, but really it's more like it's been so long. It's been like 4 to 5 years. It's been I think it's gonna be 5 years because I turned 24 in August. So it's like it's gonna be like half a decade since like I was a teenager, and it's just like that's a long time for me, you know, like. I don't know, I just have a really warped perception of time, in that, like, everything feels so much longer than it really is, while also feeling really short. So, like, a day can feel like a legitimate week, and a week can feel like a month. Yeah, rest assured, I'm technically young still, you know, I'm only 23. But currently 6 years younger than you. I still feel confused with time. Yeah. Wait, hold on. Let me do the math real quick. 6 years younger than 23 turning 24. So you're like 18. Okay. You know what? Hey, you got, like, listen, I was like that too. This isn't a new thing for me, being terrible with time. Like, I've always been terrible with time. Okay, so we gotta get a teddy bear and bring it. I'm sorry, I'm like multitasking, talking to you and also figuring out the side quest. So there's a teddy bear in presumably Sweetheart's Castle. I gotta get it back. But yeah, like, I mean, I've always had like a terrible perception of time. I think it's not really an age thing. I think it's just like it's probably like an ADHD thing. Listen, I don't, wait. Did I math wrong? I'm not Tip Aquos with math. Which isn't to really say that she's necessarily, like, better than me at math, but, like, she can do programming, and I can't wrap my head around it. Which is... I know that kind of involves math. All I'm saying is that when I did do school, when I was in the school, I was never the best at Oppa Gangnam Style. Oppa Gangnam Style. There's like a Steve Aguna remix of this song where it's Gangnam Style, and it's all I can think of whenever I hear this song. 17, you know what? I was, alright, so I was off by like... I was off by a year, okay, off by one. That's like a thing, you know, I'm allowed to be off by 1 year, you know? Alright, and now I'm just, even though I am not confident that this will kill, I'm going to bread slice. Oh, we did kill. All right, good. We got the bread. Yo, let's LGBT. Let's get bread together. But like white bread or wheat or pumpernickel, I guess. I've never had pumpernickel, but I just really think it's funny. All right, let's deal with these spiders. The more I play like this game, the more it's like, cause like back in like February of this year, I was working on my own RPG Maker game. Yo, based, flatbread, based. I just eat. Whatever bread my family gets, which is normally just white bread, because it's versatile. You know, it's also great for buttered toast in the morning, which pairs nicely with eggs, you know, a good old scramble. Which I definitely say, because it's like the only, breakfast food that, like, I know how to cook. Twitch is loading. Oh, no. Hero's afraid of spiders also. Okay, I need to heal up Aubrey. Oh, wait. I think I need to... You're back. Welcome back. I think I need, is Kel's, yeah, I need to, add running gun, because flex running gun. I think. I'm just gonna, like, reorganize his skills real quick. And, yeah, I'll keep Annoy. So fun fact, I don't make tea, because last time I tried to make tea, it wasn't good. I can't make tea, I tried making, okay, well I say this as if I've recently tried to make tea. Last time I tried to make tea, I was in high school, but, like, I was probably just a dumb, stupid kid, because I think I just microwaved water, added some honey, and, like, dipped a tea bag in for a little bit, and it just tasted awful. I'm more of a coffee person, you know? I like coffee. It just tastes good. You know? Alright, you know what? Listen, I never claimed to be the brightest bulb, especially in my youth. Despite the fact it was obviously grilled. despite the fact I'm only 23, I'm referring to my teenage years as my youth. One could argue I'm still within the range of time that could be described as youthful, as I am just a funky 23-year-old dumbass. I'm gonna look in the mirror. Floating mirror, your friends smile warmly behind you. I think I tried to, like, boil water in, like, a pot that you would, that you would make, pasta in. Yeah, I mean, I'm not even gonna, like, try to, like, I don't think I really expressed it that much, but I like to meme on the Europeans, especially the British, because, you know, I don't know, it's just funny to me. Not like in any serious way, just like post-ironic. I don't know what I'm saying, I'm just like, just British, you know? Okay, and Hiro is still afraid. I don't know, but like, I will concede that, the tea I drink is iced tea, you know, like an American. I don't make tea, I drink it from the bottle. Nice and cold. What? Alright, so I'm gonna assume, since you said, let the English friend make tea, no Americans, that you're probably English yourself. How do you feel about, like, bottled iced tea that, like, Americans just, like, drink? You know? I feel like it could be reasonably be seen as a heresy to all of tea, you know, since it... Alright, you know, that's funny. Okay. Alright, oh. Of course, can I, okay. I need Kel to not die. Hopefully. Put the fucking bottle tea down before I put you down. that's so funny. I'm just gonna come out and say it. I'm a bit of a heretic, you know. I drink bottled iced tea, and every second Thursday of the week, I come home from my job at the economics factory, and I don't know where I'm going. I don't have a job at the economics factory. Oh wait, I can get bread. I can get bread. LGBT, let's get bread together. That's what Omori says every time he does a bread slice. He's like, yeah, I'm LGBT. Let's get bread together. Oh, 68 clams? It's so close to being nice. Damn. Daniel. Damn, Daniel, back at it again with the white bands. The web's too strong to be cut. Oh, no. Oh, it's a cat. Is it Miwo? Oh, that's not a cat. Okay, avoid the cat spy door. Aw, why? I don't want to deal with the cat spider. Spider cat. It is a cat that's also a spider. I gotta deal with, okay. Is it this way? Oh, it's something. Hello. Goodbye, something. I will read chat in a second. I'm just like hyper focused on. Oh, it's Basil. Got a magical bean. Can't tell if Amori is arrow ace or is just or is such a massive introvert that he's just thrown into that group anyway. You know, honestly, yeah, Brazil. It's Basil. It's Brazil. Welcome to the Lost Forest, where you find things you never knew you were lost in the first place. Or perhaps they've forgotten for a reason. I'm gonna save. Yeah, imagine if I feel like this meme's probably been done already, but the flag of Brazil, but with Basil on it, like just like I don't know. Instead of like the middle part, it's just a picture of Basil. And last first thing you never knew, or perhaps you forgot for a reason. All right, Daddy Long Legs, where am I? Where go? Is this way? Boobs. Yeah. So true, so true. Shout out to Booba, my favorite Teletubby. That's my... I can't think of Booba, like, the word, without thinking about it being a... Because how it just sounds like a Teletubby. Someone say boobs. Hi, Coolzo. Welcome to the stream. We're talking about our favorite Teletubbies. Mine is Booba. Alright, can I do anything here? Oh, I found something. I suppose we all hold secrets. No matter how lost or how deep down we bury them, they find their way back to the other side. Oh, it's an enemy. Like the sun baby? Oh, these are ghost bunnies. We weren't actually talking about our favorite Teletubbies. I just keep having a reoccurring bit where I just say Booba's my favorite Teletubby because Booba, like the word for boobs, sounds vaguely like, yeah, thighs of Booba? I like personality. I'm bisexual. I appreciate all forms of art. It is. I am. You know, you nailed it on the head. I am, as they say, upstate New York. Pansexual. Although sometimes I just say I'm bisexual. Because, like, I mean, really, like, it's just a matter of semantics at the end of the day, from my perspective, like, but it's all the same sentiment, really, like, I mean, I don't know. I know it's not really just, like, all semantics, but, like, I don't know, there's just, I have reasons. It's a lot easier sometimes to just say I'm bi than it is to explain what being pan is like, you know? Like, it's just like, you know, less complicated. And sometimes you just need the less complicated answer. So, yeah. That's that on that. I don't know where I'm supposed to go. Do I go up? No. Do I go east? Do I go west? I do. Trying to lose yourself, or have you accomplished that already? Either way, this is the right place for you. Perhaps that's why you've come here, to finish the job. Alright, you know what, Buster? Daddy long legs. Okay, so I gotta go right, or no, left. And then up. Nope, okay. I feel like there's probably like... Okay. Usually we tend to do things we want as opposed to things we say we would do. I've never been one for once. I'm more of a need kind of person. I suggest you look for an exit before your needs become more apparent. Why the hell do Argonians have bigger honker donker bazonkers than Nords? It's because lizard people should be allowed to be sexy. And I think, you know, I think you would have been cowardly of Bethesda to deny us the right to sexy lizard men and women. You're still here? You must have either given up or you have fully embraced your fate. A confession, perhaps, but I'm not the one to tell. Alright, you know what? I'm getting real sick of this. I'm getting real sick of this place. I feel like there was probably a hint somewhere, and I just blatantly missed it. But by God damn it, I will brute force my way through here while avoiding the spider. Cats. There was a boy wandering around here before. Very familiar to you. Very similar to you. Well, for Scaly, just not in public. Alright, you know what? You know what? It's the duality of man, you know, duality of mankind. We cannot have cat girls without lizard men. You know, it's just, it wouldn't be fair, you know? I think all animal people are created equal. And if people are allowed to be on twitch.gov, you know, twitch.tv/gov, /google.com, as a funky little cat girl, I think you should be allowed to be a lizard person as well. You know, I'm just gonna say it. Controversial opinion or not. I don't know what I'm fucking talking about. I'm just fucking lost. How regretful it must have been to never find what he was looking for. Be it regret, defeat, or confusion, no one will know. Alright, I'm tired. I'm so tired of being tired. Alright, can I go back? Alright, probably not since this... Alright. What, do I... Alright, I don't know if I've tried here. Oh! Gasp. Gazpacho. Picked up a pearl. I don't know what that's for. I'd rather just be able to switch reproduction organs in human. I can be half dragon later. You know what, that's... Alright, so like, I'll concede that like... whatchamacallit? I'll concede that like if I had like a genie wish or whatever the fuck, and like I had to choose between like animal people being real or like people being able to have reproductive organs would make them the most comfortable, I would probably go with the one that's would alleviate gender dysphoria more likely, which is to say the reproductive organs. But it's just a fun thought, you know? I think humanity is cowardly in their lack of desire. Not necessarily desire, but for, you know, I know we have a lot of problems in the world, you know? I know there's a lot of problems, but I just think that humanity would be a better place if we concentrated our efforts into genetically modifying cat girls. You know, definitely, 100%, totally. I think that we should just forget all the other problems exist and they'll just definitely 100% go away for sure. 100%, definitely, for sure. I've seen Lost and I've seen Blind, but the combination is unsettling. Perhaps you're hiding away from the right way. Okay. Morals are lost and wicked. How does one define malice without intent? Why do you continue down this path when it's most certainly not the right way? Catgirls with both, those will take over before robots. Yes. The catgirl revolution will begin. Like Nya, am I right? Oh, God damn it, I went down the wrong path.
I am tired of going down the wrong path.
Oppa Gangnam style. Listen, I'm just saying, you know. Dismantle the. I think the cat. If we had cat girls, they would dismantle the establishment. Board by board. I'm going to get bread. I've got some. Oyera, believe that, cat girls will dismantle the establishment for sure, and 7 years ago. I liked you. One time I was in playing VR chat with some friends, and I don't know who 45 is. I feel like I probably should, as in American. But I don't think about most presidents. Fuck. I fucked up. 46 is current. Oh, yeah. I don't, they say it's 45 would be easier. Or, not they, but... You're not, like, the first person to suggest that, is what I'm getting at. Like, people have said that 45 would be easier. As an impression, but surprisingly, I have a hard time. You know, I just my concentrated brain efforts are more importantly focused on Kermit the Frog.
Booba. My God. I'm going to read the rest of the voices in this game in this shitty little Kermit voice. Did I talk to this guy? There's an old saying about wasting time when living a life that is not your own. Dreams can feel that way. Dreams can feel like this forest, lost.
Fuck!
Fuck!
God, I just realized you and Aquas could have a conversation as Kermit and Elmo talking about Pooba.
We totally could!
I also like to do a Toad voice, but it's a lot more ear-piercing and terrible. So, this is your preemptive warning for a Toad voice. It's coming in 3, 2, 1.
Hello! I'm Toad! Oh, by golly! Sometimes when we hide things from ourselves, we create different truths and eventually forget our way. Have you found yours yet? Or are you still lost? Fuck!
Not annoying enough? Alright, you know what? That is a fair analysis of the Toad voice. It could definitely be more annoying. I just feel like if it was, it would definitely murder my throat in more ways than it already does, kinda. Because I can't, I think, I forget what I was playing. I was playing some fucking video game. I say as if it's like not a Mario game. I was playing some Mario game and like, or I think at least, I was playing something and I just read everything in a Toad voice. My throat was just absolutely destroyed. Also, Pog, Omori has just enough juice left to, get bread. Lucky Slice? Oh, well. Alright, I'm gonna look at what Lucky Slice does. Attacks three times, hitting random foes. Acts first, an attack that's stronger when Omori is happy. Okay, so he's not gonna be happy very often, so I'm not gonna make him happy. So I'm not gonna use Lucky Slice. Lucky Slice, my favorite anime. About, Star of Life. And just making a fucking joke about Lucky Star. The anime that, Aquos watches sometimes. Or at least she showed me once, and I was like, does anything happen? Do they just talk about food the whole time? She was like, yeah! anyways, I'm time to fucking fuck up these ghost bunnies.
Ugh. Colonel, I'm trying to fuck up these ghost bunnies. But the clap of my ass cheeks keeps alerting the guards.
Can I stop getting lost? Okay, I know most of the way. You're recording a snake thing for you. Oh, shit. Okay. Hell yeah. It's probably astronomically better than any snake voice I could ever muster. Forget all you will or try to. Darkness manifests whether you are aware or not. Hide the inhabitable behind ignorance and watch your lie fall. The darkness surrounds you, and it is a terrible thing, but your truth has guided you. How much longer can you keep it? Alright, so there's seemingly only one way forward. Oh shit, it's a cutscene. You have reached the end of the lost forest, but the beginning of the truth. Alright. I will tell you a story that has been lost through time. A story about the creation of this reality. In the beginning, there only existed two. The dreamer and his room. The dreamer grew weary of his room and created a door that led to many different worlds. Walking the path as a visitor to these worlds, the dreamer would come and go as he pleased. Slips and falls, tumbles and drops. The dreamer's curiosity and clumsy exploration eventually led him to a certain world. One not like the others. One painted with chaos and bathed in darkness. The dreamer slowly became filled with dread. Quiet as they may have been, words of malice quietly crept into his mind, whispering lies, secrets, and truths. Powerless to silence the noise, the dreamer manifested benevolent entities in his different worlds. Then he compounded his worlds above the dark realm, sealing it with their combined might. Yet despite his valiant efforts, the darkness's presence never abated. Even with new allies, the darkness continued to scrape and scratch at the back of the dreamer's mind. The noise might have subsided, but it never went away. The dreamer could run and bury his fears, but one still has to face his own reflection. What the dreamer had created was something he could not be a part of, something outside himself. The dreamer's own power was his greatest adversary. Knowledge, or the absence of it, would become the dreamer's greatest gift. To truly escape the perils of his own faculty and ascend to a blissful state of ignorance, Only then would the noise cease to agitate the dreamer's sanity. So, the dreamer took on another name, and chose to forget himself. From that time on, the dreamer has lived amongst us. Among us? Sus? Send it over now. Spoiler, it's bad. Hey, you know, it can't be that bad. Can't be that bad. As someone who has a shitty toad impression, it can't be that bad. From that time on, the dreamer had lived amongst us. Ah, yes, amongst us. When the faker is suspicious. I finally found you, faker. Faker, I think you're the fake hedgehog around here. You're not even good enough to be my fake. I don't know how. I'm a fake Sonic fan. I can't even quote Sonic. It simply is an inhabitant of this world, traveling along blissfully, ignorant of his own fabrication. Children, I must warn you. As with all things that are born in and out of this world, an end will threaten this one too. Though the dreamer may have subdued the inexorable, the darkness grows still. No bandage can stifle an eternal wound, and there will be a time when its influence will bleed through. Forgetful the dreamer may be of this peril, a peril never forgets to be. Yet the end of this world may be an inevitability. The dreamer is the only one with the ability that can truly set this world free. Can I move now? Oh, it's a fire. And the daddy long legs is going into the fire. And now he's gone. Into the fire. Ooh, is that an H? Or... I think it's an H. H. Yo, beast. Based on what? You mean to tell me a shrimp has fried this rice? The fire and flames? Yeah, it's... On a cold winter morning, in a time before the light, with flames are dancing eternally, on a time before the night. I don't know the words. Running hard, running up forward, stealing a wasteland nevermore. The scattered souls will feel the hell, that bodies wasted on the shore. In the darkest days, the gentle rain will bless us all. Time flames, I could probably do a Jetstream Sam cosplay if I grew up my hair more. Well, I don't know who Jetstream Sam is, but, you know, I think growing out hair is poggers. Alright, so that's the end of the Forest of Misery. In pain, in suffering... I want this watermelon. A faux tail. Oh my god, someone's gonna be a furry. Alright, who gets the faux tail? Alright, it's Kel. Kel, you get the faux tail. Actually, wait. He increases his hit rate. Alright, he gets the faux tail. And then, do I give Omori this? Yeah. Okay. Now to focus again to make sure I didn't miss any item. Damn it. Alright, you know what? I think I'm good. I think I didn't miss anything. I'm deciding actually, and I'm just gonna leave this place and go back to the other place. The place without this place.
But first, there's a bear! I'm
gonna heal up first. I'm not making a mistake. I refuse. I can never be made a mistake. Cat ear? Okay, is it Aubrey? Is Aubrey gonna become a cat? 10 speed and 1 defense? Okay. No, I think it's... Alright. Sunny is a cat boy. And then Aubrey gets the seer goggles. Single block of tofu. Bop ba da bop bop. I forget if I had a picnic with my friends here already, so I'm just gonna do this again. How are you handling your fear of spiders, hero? Breathe in. Breathe out. You're doing great, hero. Keep at it. Huff. Breathe in. Huff. Breathe out. Mora used to be scared of spiders too, but look at him now. Not even a flinch. Look how brave he's being. Wow. So brave. Such brave. Many wow. Alright, so... I think... I mean, okay, so like, I know I... this is probably a mistake. Okay, actually wait, shit, I need to look up the fucking, I need to look up the, type effectiveness. So this, he's angry, so I need to make people happy. Angry. Or I can make angry. Actually, wait. She has... Aubrey has, things that make happy, right? Why would I want a person to attack Hero for one turn? That just sounds awful. He is the healer. Oh gosh, that dealt a lot of damage. Not succumb. It's up to you. Yeah. Hello, stranger. I am Mush, and my lifelong dream has always been to be eaten and enjoyed. Will you finally grant my wish and eat me? Yes. Oh, thank you, stranger. You don't know how grateful I am for this. You got Mush. You are afraid of drowning. Okay. I'm gonna go and heal, since, yeah. I did fight a rare bear. Ever since I learned the strat in my first alright, so when I first did a playthrough, like, back in, like, January of 2021, I learned from a good friend of mine, the strat of flex and running gun. And ever since then, my, I just, you know, I understand. Well, okay, that's simplified. Like, flex running gun is, like, pretty good for, like, dealing a lot of damage if you're up against, like, a boss or something. Yeah. Subsequent. Okay. Alright, I think, haha, yo, Mercy Winks, you're a Gruta level 12, that's so pog, I'm so based. Based on what? Yo, thanks, as a woman I enjoy being complimented, so, yeah. Muchas gracias. Alright, so there's gotta be a fucking railroad track here that I just missed, clearly. So now I'm gonna be focusing. Please do not touch me, spider cats. I fucked up. Okay, so it's not the middle area. Is it to the left? Actually, I think it's to the right because I went to the left earlier, I think. I think maybe. Hold on a second. Hello? Just my father asking about dinner. My apologies. My apple of geese. I'm having a hamburger with tomato. You know what they say, you can't spell tomato without toe. Where the hell is this final thing? Railroad track. I can't remember. Somebody tells me it's not through here. Unless I already picked it up and I'm just stupid. I'm gonna try interacting with the empty spot and see if I'm just stupid. I'm hoping I'm just stupid in that, rail track and missing a segment. Oh, I'm not stupid. Okay. I'm just stupid. Maybe I missed something. Did I go over here? Okay, I did miss something. It is over there. I just gotta be better scrub. Okay. Okay. I feel like I'm going to have to do this a bunch. Or not. I got the wooden track. Okay.
Okay.
Now I'm gonna heal up. Because it never hurts to heal. Bop it up, bop, bop. You know, minecart tracks. What is this, Minecraft? I didn't know Omori was a Minecraft-like. Because everyone knows the only video games that are allowed to have minecarts in them are Minecraft. Of course. Sometimes I just say things that are blatantly false, like in a sarcastic tone. Oh, it exploded. Block game. Block game. They should make Omori DLC for Minecraft. It'll be so epic. Reskin the diamond sword to be a kitchen knife. But up, up, up. Is that insensitive actually to say? I don't know. I hope it's not. I don't like, saying things that, are insensitive or being insensitive. I like keeping things, you know, nice and chill. Just a goof, you know, based on this game where Omori's primary weapon is a kitchen knife. Anyways, it's minecart time. Woo, baby! That's what I've been waiting for. Woo! Subsequent Psybeam. Yo, we're in the castle already? Eating an orange spoonless percent. Oh my god. Such a niche callback. I love it. Hi, Ross. Welcome to the stream. I'm playing Amori. Basil, are you here? Basil, where are you? Where are you? And I'm so sorry. Doesn't look like Basil is here either. Hey, look, it's Mari. Mari. Oh. Oh, hello, everyone. Hello there. You all made it through the forest. I say Basil, but that could just be me being an American. I have heard in media it pronounces Basil before, but I say Basil. Oh, hello. Hello there. You all made it through the forest. I'm so proud of you. Mari, I was so scared. Aww, they hug. Hero, this is kind of embarrassing. It's times like these I really wish Basil was here. He could tell Hero about how spiders are harmless and good for nature or something. Maybe then he wouldn't find them so creepy. I'm not sure if that would help him right now. Oh, Hero, you're going to have to deal with this eventually. These things will only get worse over time. Maybe. Or maybe I'll naturally outgrow it. You never know what the future brings. Alright, and now we heal. We're gonna have a picnic. The picnic basket. Hey, boo-boo, it's a picnic basket. Oh. Yogi the bear. This forest is a lot scarier than the one near the playground. And a lot older, too. It does have a mysterious air about it, doesn't it? I heard there used to be a huge library filled with books here, but since no one took care of it, over time the library slowly sank into the ground. Who told you that, Mari? Oh, just some shadows here and there. If you focused, you could see them too. That's not ominous or anything. Whatever, reading is boring. Who wants to read anyways? You tell it, Cal. Kel. Where's this library now, Mari? Well, if I were to guess, I'd say it would be right beneath us. Like, underground? Yeah, somewhere around here, probably. And then we go to save, because saving is important. I'll also use my clams. Yes, hello, valued customer. Please, welcome to my shop. Please buy something. Do I have... I don't think this game does, like, junk items. Oh, gold watch. Oh, whoa, or ooh, woo. That is a question. It depends. You know, I can go both ways on that. Alright, I'm gonna get, two dandelions. Bunch of nachos. I don't know. I feel like I use ooh-woo more often than oh-wo, but that's not to downplay the importance of a good oh-wo. Actually, no, I think it's the other way around, and I'm just stupid. Because I'd like to say, oh, whoa, but like, O-W-O-A-H. Like, oh, whoa, you know? Like, kind of spell it out. That's a weird sprout mole. Best ada ada. Like, do you want me to give an ara ara or ada ada or whatever? Or are you asking me what the best ada ada I've heard? Because I haven't heard very many ada adas. I'm rolling the R's instinctively. Not because I'm a weeb, but because I'm a gamer. Turn back. Ada ada. You know, like that. I've only heard like fucking Genshin Impact ada ada. So like I don't know like how it goes. But yeah, ada ada. Mada mada. Oh, these are a bunch of dead sprout moles. Are these robots? Oh, I just that was a very juicy break. Oh no. Oh, it's an enemy. It's a giant enemy spider. Okay, I don't want to have to waste a Kel turn. Actually, wait. Probably. Just use the present on Hero's turn. Actually. Setting up emotions. Please don't kill Kel. Damn it! Okay, this is not looking good. Okay, this is extra not good. Okay. Well, alright, I did just buy nachos. And, which one? Life Jam. It really works. I just noticed this guy is made of sprout molds. That's so creepy. Oh, this also causes her to take damage. Okay. Oh no, Aubrey. Don't become toast. You're so Aubrey, uh-huh. I have a lot of tasty soda. Okay. It's time for the ultimate attack. And everyone wasn't dead at the end, so everyone leveled up. Hero learned fast food.
But what if I were to purchase fast food and disguise it as my own cooking? Ho ho, delightfully devilish, Seymour.
Alright, I'm gonna go and heal. Because I don't know if it's... Alright. Good game design, it would indicate that there would be a picnic basket after that. Actually, no, that's not even good game design. That's just, like, decent game design. Not inherently good, not inherently bad. Just, like, okay, you know? It's a good quality of... It would be good quality. Not quality, but, like, it would be a good time save, is what I mean. I was gonna say quality of life, but it's not inherently even that. Like, it's not that big a deal just to backtrack right to the last picnic basket. But it would be, you know, nice if as soon as you went down the ladder, there was another one to heal you up so you don't have to go back. But it's not a requirement. Like, this is perfectly fine without it. Oh, and of course it is there. Okay, so it is, you know, good game design. After all. Typical merchandise of an obnoxious looking person. Hello, strange looking sprout moles. Are you here to see Sweetheart's Quest for Hearts? So you've come to the right place. The sold out extravaganza spectacular will be starting very shortly. Wait a second, I know the show. We have front row show tickets for it. Ah, I can see it now. A dazzling epic tale about the hardships of romance. Heartbreak, betrayal, desperation, loneliness. Oh, the drama. This is gonna be so fun. I can't wait to be swept off my feet. I don't know. I guess it looks interesting? But now doesn't seem like the right time. But you promised we would earlier. Please, hero, we should at least check it out. Please, 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 please. Well... Alright, hopefully this won't take too long. Ahem, if I may have your show tickets, please. Yes, yes, of course, Mr. Sproutmole, sir. We have our tickets right here. Aubrey reached into your pocket and took out the show tickets. Here you go, Mr. Sproutmole. Oh my, I can't believe my eyes. These are front row tickets. You all must have made some great sacrifices to be here today. I applaud you. Forgive me for calling you strange looking earlier. At a second glance, you four are the most normal-looking sprout moles I have ever seen. Please enjoy your front row seats, fellow normal-looking sprout moles. Sprout moles are such funny little creatures. I just want to pick one up and squish it. Gee, did you know? Sprout moles really love tofu. I brought some tofu at a tofu stand earlier. Feel free to try some. You got tofu. Some juicy tomatoes. Bop it up, bop, bop. Fidget. Hush. Hey, you there. You creatures seem like well-seasoned travelers. Could you help me out? My brother lives in the Sproutmill colony in Otherworld. I want to send him a care package, but I'm afraid of getting lost. Would you be able to deliver it for me? Thank you, strange creatures. I'm sure he'll appreciate it. Here you go. A care package. Make sure it gets to him safely. I hate Mondays. Family mole. We Sproutmills do not dare leave the colony ever since the Great Move. It was a hard time. Many of us didn't make it. Sproutmills were getting lost left and right. Children were separated from their families. Oh, the horror! I mean, at least it's all okay now, for the most part. Hey you, you're finally awake. Yes. I'm going to go back and travel real quick to do this side quest before I forget. Station Pluto Space Line. You wanna wait here for Pluto? Yes. Yes I do. Hentai too. Space Line, where would you like to go? Other world. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. I'm also going to go back and tend to the flowers, and hopefully it'll let me. Gwahahaha! Ha 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 ha! I remember that the flowers are important. Actually, wait, I think I'm going the wrong way to get to where I need to go to. A lonely crow picks at the dirt. It doesn't seem to notice you.
Okay!
Oh wait, it's an unidentified flying orange. Oh my god. Cause it's flying. Oh god, that's a lot of them. Ah, a stranger. It's Mr. Scarecrow. Thank you for having time to talk with me. I apologize, I'm afraid I must burden you with a task I cannot complete with my own capabilities. Quite recently, a rogue planet burst across the sky at an alarmingly fast pace. My three dearest friends panicked and flew off in separate directions. My three friends are crows, you see, and are not the most friendly nor welcoming creatures. I'm a bit wary to ask such an immense favor from a complete stranger, but there aren't many who pass through these fields. If I may ask, would you be willing to help my dear friends? Thank you, stranger. Words cannot begin to express what this means to me. Now I shall await their return patiently. For as you can see, without them, I am just a stick in the mud. Alright, you know, I'm just surely these guys can't have too much health. Yeah, they go down one. I could theoretically use this as an opportunity to farm for, oh, my cat just walked in front of my face. I could use this to farm for bread, but I don't feel like it. Am I a MILF? I don't think I am a mother. So, I'm gonna have to say on a technicality, no. But, I appreciate the sentiment. I need to get my cat off of my desk. Because he is going in front of my webcam. think he wants to get out of my room, but, like, it's a lot of work. Crow doesn't want to talk to you. Perhaps if you're someone more charming? Okay. I see how it is. Greetings, my feathered friend. Would you like to return to Mr. Scarecrow? He can't wait to be with you again. Oh, I did pick him up like a long cat. You just can't see because, funky VTuber avatar go burr. Caw, caw. I guess that would be immensely desirable. Place him on the ground, and then he just walks off to somewhere else in my room. He's one of those cats that really like affection, and will not like run away if you try to pet him. Shoot, I know I left my donut somewhere around here. Back at it again with the fucking orangnes. Can I get a upstate New York? There's one thing you need to know about me is I quote Steam Tams way too often for the year 2022. Alright. Do I have to be Omori to give him the donut? Okay, he's just telling me that there is a donut. Isn't the sky beautiful? It's nice to know there are so many others out there who share the same view. Ooh, a thing. Simpsons is about 40 years old. You're fine. Yeah, but, like, Steamed Hams was, like, a meme, like, in, like, 2018 or something. I feel like its meme status has kind of, like, deteriorated over the years. But that could just be me personally, because I quote it all the fucking time, because I have it, like, damn near memorized. If need be, I can recite it from memory. That is a trait of mine, and that's just how it be. What is a meme anymore? The DNA of the soul? Memes are the DNA of the soul, if you didn't know. Wow, miss, you sure are tall. Thank you, little one. It's more of a hassle most of the time, but I do get a better view of the stars. Wait, being tall isn't a hassle? What? Being tall isn't a hassle? Everything is better when you're tall. One day I'm gonna be as tall as you. Yeah, sure, Kel, keep dreaming. See, as someone who is tall, I think Kel doesn't understand that being tall isn't always great. Also, my dinner's done, so, like, I'm, like, conflicted. Do I take a brief intermission to go eat food, or do I simply, I mean, I don't know, I'm, like, 6'2", but, like, if I had a choice, I would not be 6'2". Like, there's nothing wrong with being tall, it's just not for me, but, like, I don't really have a say in that. How bad can a shark plane be? Yeah, I'm like contemplating, do I like just take a brief break? Like, do I just go on Be Right Back to eat Bubger, or do I just eat Bubger after I finish eating? These are the questions I must ask myself. I like how the UFOs don't hurt Kyoto. Power hit? That sounds powerful. Intermission if you get a picture of it? Okay, you know what? Maybe. Just maybe. Let me see what's up over here. My friends used to live in these tunnels, but they all left to look for their missing leader. Do you think they'll ever come back here? Oh no. We Sprontmoles are highly intelligent creatures. Most horse first place. Oh my god. Need to find out who I'm supposed to deliver this package to. Greetings, traveler. Welcome to my home. It is humble and small, but it is mine. The sprout mole is super glued to the wall. That's funny. Now that's funny. I don't care who you are. That's funny. Huh? What's that? You have a package for me? Give the care package to your brother Mole. Hey, this is from my brother. Wow, there's 99 tofu in here. This is the best gift ever. He knows me too well. Thanks for the delivery. You know, I was saving this for a rainy day, but now that I have my care package, I won't need it anymore. Got life jam. Shit. Slurp. Tofu. So good. Yeah, I was born in 1990-something. I was born in the 90s, like an epic 90s gamer. Because I am, like, 23, turning 24. Wait, I just realized that you're probably not born in the 90s. Probably, you're definitely not. That's so weird. Shiny telescope. Let's check out the view. Is there anything, is the spider on the moon? It's like the moonwalk. Oh my god. forgotten if you've reacted to the video from earlier. I'll just send you memes later. Hell yeah. No password, no entry. Okay. Let me get somewhere I can go. Message in a bottle. Let's read it. When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. You can play the message through the bottle back in the lake. Okay. Let me. Oh, that's a lot of things. Why? 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 This better be worth it. A blanket. Defense 10 heart. 4 memes coming your way? Hell yeah. Fuck yeah. Love me some good old-fashioned memes, as I say one word at a time, as I chop down these traffic cones, as they never stop. I mean, technically, they do, but it's a hassle. Hey, what's the big idea? I went through all the trouble isolating myself from society, and then you show up and ruin everything. You better fix this right now. Oh my god. You don't even... Oh my god, you helped the Strutton reassemble all the traffic cones. Not even a payoff. Stars sure seem pretty, huh? I can really lose myself staring into the sky like this. Back on my planet, you can hardly see any stars. When I grow up, I want to be a space captain. Then I'll be able to view them all the time. Oh shoot, how long have I been here? Mom and Dad are probably super worried about me. I better head home quick. You missed nothing except a side quest I forgot I was doing. Alright, and okay, no, not this way. Do I go this way? Yes, I do. Hentai too. Alright, I'm gonna go save and take a brief intermission to eat food. Buff, 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 buff. Alright. You know, I'm just quoting Samuel L. Jackson. That's another meme. I just say things sometimes that I've heard elsewhere that are just kind of funny. Like, to quote Samuel L. Jackson, yes I do, comma, hentai too. Yeah. Anyways. Stairs, motherfucker. Alright, Alright, let's go back. So use psychic power. You know what? That's so true. I just need to unlock my 57th eye, and I will gain the psychic ability to control wireless controllers that are not connected to the console. Yo, you ready for some can? Actually, wait. I was gonna say can ASMR, because I have an unopened can of carbonated orange juice on my desk. But I also have another can that's of the same beverage that is already opened, but that I was drinking earlier. I'm just gonna finish drinking that. You will be saved the trouble of carbonation in the orange juice form for now, or at least the refreshing sound of. No, it's not orange soda. Technically, it contains 6% orange juice, but it is technically a seltzer water. But I like just calling it carbonated orange juice because it may, at least to my friends, it's always like, why not just drink regular orange juice? And it's like, because I don't have any. Oregon. So true, so true. Gotta love a good lasagna. I introduced my younger sister to the concept of Garfield the other day. It was a time. She then sent me a letter in Animal Crossing about a cat who hates Mondays and loves lasagna. Ah yes, welcome. You must be here to learn about the best culinary feats in sliced bread. Tofu. Yeah. C'est magnifique. I don't have an opinion on Garfield. I just liked, as a kid, the movie with Bill Murray. Here's your tofu trivia for the day. The best way to add flavor to tofu is to glaze it until golden, then add a marinade. It will absorb all the flavors until the sauce becomes syrup that sticks to the pan. If you wish to know more about the amazing and majestic tofu, feel free to talk to me again. Ho ho! How you speak such blasphemy. It is only common knowledge that tofu is better when served hot. Are you mad? Any sprout mole with decent knowledge knows that tofu is best served cold. Hey there, there's no need to fight. Why don't you two come to a compromise? Who knows? Maybe you're both right. Or maybe you can cook tofu in a way that hasn't been done yet. Somewhere between hot and cold. Like, I don't know. Lukewarm? Ew. Lukewarm tofu? That's the worst idea I've ever heard. Even cold tofu is better than that. Lukewarm tofu? I wanted to throw up. Even hot tofu is better than that. They came to an agreement. Hell yeah. This room is for sprout moles only. No humans allowed. I cannot be disturbed right now. This room is occupied. This wall is nice and cold. Hey, look at this cool thing I drew. Oh my god. It's fucking... It's the thing! It's the 1S thing that children draw. Do you think we'll all still be friends after we graduate? I don't know. Despite all my rage, I am still just a mole in a cage. Mumbo jumbo. I have no idea what I'm doing. Yo, so true. Same bestie. Is this the way I came down? Yeah. I need to get better at navigation. It never hurts to have tofu on you at all times. I know I've gotten out of plenty of sticky situations with tofu. Look at me! I am truly the most beautiful sprout mole, am I not? Sure thing, buddy. Hello, sir or madam, would you be interested in purchasing some fine tofu? It will cost you exactly one clam. I did. Is there something about burgers and 7 p.m? Got tofu. Alright, I'm just gonna be welcome to the ASMR power hour of buying tofu one at a time until I max out on tofu. I mean, I get, they can be a lunch thing, but like, they can also be a dinner thing. Sometimes. It depends. It's one of those things where, at least to me, it's kind of like lunch and dinner. You know, it's so funny, because for lunch today, I had pizza. So, like, I ate pizza at, like, 1, and a burger at, like, 7. Like, this is going to take a while. Alright, wait. What happens if I talk to this guy? Hello, sir. Man, I'm producing some tofu. Costs you exactly 1 clan. Oh, it's the same guy. Weighted blankets can be pog. They're less pog when your cats and dogs destroy them and get the beads that are inside all over your bed. And that's been my experience with weighted blankets. They're pog until they're not pog, but they're only not pog when there's outside forces causing them to not be pog. Yo, Pog. I have 30. Alright, you know. I can't buy this in bulk, and I'm getting bored. So I'm leaving. I will go back for tofu later. Maybe do that off screen. It's a mirror. Floating mirror, your friends smile warmly behind you. Faster, men, we must push ourselves to the limit and strive for a brighter tomorrow. Yo, a 50-pound weighted blanket, that sounds, like a lot of weight. I'm not one to judge, though. That's like a whole dog. An entire dog. The humble abode of Rosa, the number one sweetheart fan in the world. Oh shit. Ah, summer, the sand, the sun, the beach, the waves, not to mention summer vacation. Finally, some time for rest and relaxation. That's what life is all about. Summer is not the best season. I will go with spring. Spring brings us beauty. Spring brings us joy. Spring brings us life. Spring brings us a rejuvenating spirit to start things anew. Spring is the best season. Oh, I just remembered. I'm an idiot. I forgot to go. Oh my god. I forgot to water the flowers. I need to go do that. Up. I was so preoccupied with the thought of buying tofu that I forgot about watering the flowers. Poor Kel, as he always has to, like, hang on for dear life. I bet all the flowers are gonna be dead, and I'm gonna... Oh, God, I can already see dead flowers. Oh, God. Pluto is a planet? I kid. Yeah, he's just a ball with arms. He's like Geodude. Oh, that's probably my, father or something. People are in the living room. My room is right next to the living room. My apologies for, noise. Sometimes I think about just using my headset mic, because then it won't, like, background noise won't get picked up, but then the audio quality is gonna be a lot worse, and it's like, do I want to, like, sacrifice audio quality for, like... Yeah, I am. They all know about the transgenderedness. I feel like, logistically, I probably should have just, like, ended stream instead of, continuing. Yeah, it is good. But, like, what I was saying is, like, because, like, yeah, I did take an intermission to eat burger, but, like, I could have just, like, taken that as a means to end the stream, because as much as I've been enjoying the stream, I'm just kind of, like, I don't know. Couldn't hurt. I mean, it would have been a shorter stream, but my streams are never really that long anyways. But then again, at the same time, they're normally not that long because they normally don't have people watching them. And there's only so long you can talk to yourself before. You just gotta be like, yeah, I'm done. There's a save at the train station, which I think there might be. Quest. You know what I hate more than anything else? Bunnies. That's right. Bunnies. I just hate them so much. If I had one wish in the world, I would destroy all the world's bunnies. Hey, you look like you've defeated a few bunnies. Yeah, that's right. I can tell how many bunnies you've defeated by looking at you. That's how much I hate bunnies. Say, tell you what, let's make a deal. If you defeat at least 5 bunnies, come back and report to me. I'll give you something nice. Now go on and destroy those bunnies. Hello, funny fellow bunny hater. By looking in your eyes, I see that you've killed 22 bunnies. Splendid. I see you've destroyed more bunnies. That's 22 bunnies obliterated. Thank you so much, fellow bunny hater. Got a cotton ball. Go on and destroy more bunnies. Alright, so I need to get 25 keeled lemonade. Hello, sir or madam. Looks like we have run out of train passes. We still have some lemonade left. Do you want to buy lemonade? Yeah, lemonade sounds pretty good. Stop right there. You can't pass without a... Whoa, that's a train pass. You must be the last passenger. We've been waiting for you for a very long time. Well, that's all clear for me. Welcome aboard, patrons. Just gonna collect these items. I'm Gibbs, the stationary musician. I used to be a traveling musician, but I left that life long ago. To be able to spare five clams, they would be a great help since I am completely stationary. I'll show you something good if you do. Thank you for your donation. Now, in return, let me play you the song of my people. You thought the song was pretty good. Alright, so there isn't a safe thing here, but there might be if we go on the train. But also, okay, I'm just gonna go back. I don't think I should go to the train yet. I think I'm a bit early for the train. I know I did go all the way out here to the train station, but I think I'm a bit early for the train. Be one bunny away from the next prize. Hey, nice. Bop. Alright, and with that, I'm going to end the stream. Thank you, Admiral Cold Arms, for coming out. And for everyone else who came out and said something, you know, just kind of chill, hang. It was a good stream. Appreciate all y'all. And I'll see you all in the next one. Actually, probably not tomorrow. It's someone's birthday that I know. But, if not tomorrow, the day after, I might stream again. So, yee. I just been streaming because I just want to play Amori. Specifically the Hikikomori route, because I haven't done that yet. And that's the route we're doing currently. So I've just been streaming because I want to play the game. Yeah, I've had some other ideas where I might do this with other games, where I just stream as a means to get me to actually play the games I want to play. Because sometimes I'll, like, play games and, like, I just won't get into them, but, yeah, I don't know. It's real nice and a lot more engaging when, like, you're reading everything out loud. At least for me personally, I don't know. But, yeah, it's a good chat, and I'll see y'all later. Goodbye.